there, and then it's longer. It's longer for radius, and then it's longer when you put it in your pocket.
Good.
Mm.
Josh?
Yeah, that is really good.
Moxie's her character's name, and her player's name is spelled funny. Haley.
Okay.
Pronounce Haley with an E. Dante,
so
Melissa.
Everybody's got a mini.
Don't tell me.
Taylor.
Taylor. Do you guys? Oh, you guys need name tags so you can call each other by name.
Oh, no.
So, well, we I was going to say, us three
you
know
each other.
Everybody,
so here, you can fold this in half, like Taylor has done. Oh, that's a wolf.
In different forms.
Wolf?
Like,
yeah, Melissa, where's yours?
Well, mine has Maliki on it. I'm a worshiper of Maliki.
So then you can write your player name and your character name on there so everyone knows who to call you.
You
have
one.
You
also have the unicorn.
Yeah. Well, the unicorn is sort of her thing, and because I worship her, is why.
These children also claim that they're a channel living in somewhere.
I don't know.
And that mom and dad.
But apparently, it's very important for Claire.
Monster in the house. They didn't.
This is what I understand.
So that's what brought you in.
Much better writing than I do right now.
What else did you all notice while you're going through the mansion?
That there's like weird.
Isn't Moxie from Borderlands?
No.
Wood paneling?
Several
sounds
rooms.
Expensive.
Several
well,
rooms.
It might
have
be
sort of
awesome,
carvings.
But
yeah.
Not
it might be awesome.
Where I got it from, no.
The one that Evander is standing in right now.
Where is it from?
That's my stage name. When I do magic tricks in the Rocky Horror Picture Show, it's Moxie Mayhem.
Oh,
I love Rocky Horror Picture Show.
You're going to have to back up a lot for that one. So that's your stage name when you do magic tricks at the Rocky Horror Picture Show.
Well, I'm a fire eater, fire swallower, fire spinner. I levitate razor blades, swallow razor blades. I do needle swallows, and I also play as Riff Raff in the Misfit Toys of Corona.
Okay, I know who Riff Raff is. The rest of that was pretty complicated. So, good luck, Moxie. So, last week, our fearless human sorcerer charged into the death house.
Yeah, no,
you
look
like,
charged into the death house
the
because two simulacrum children in front of the house had said that there was a monster
I guess everybody
in the house.
Forgot that the ranger was there.
Oh, the ranger was also helping out. So, you went into this house. You're in a city. The city is very deserted, very abandoned, very old and desolate. It is in a kind of a valley at the base of a large cliff. At the top of the cliff, there is a giant castle. There is fog throughout the area, right? So you interacted in a bar quickly. You've rescued or you've alleviated some of the suffering of an old woman who had lost her daughter. You interacted with some guys at a drunk bar, the Blood on the Vine bar, if I remember right. Blood on the Vine bar. They were mostly miserable and sad. You were on your way to the mayor's house to figure out. You had received a note.
I heard that the gypsies come by regularly, and the gypsies are the ones.
Oh my god, it makes me happy.
Yeah, the gypsies were a thing because we were following them when we got exactly killed, but then that was great.
Someone, you found this note that leads you to believe that the mayor is up to something and you're supposed to be, you know, spreading good and protection of their whole land because it's possessed. So inside the house, you've gone in, basically searched the first floor. On the first floor, you guys didn't really find anything. You didn't search that quickly. You were looking for a monster. You were opening doors. Several people ran upstairs. They didn't see anything on the stairs. Started going through the rooms. There was a library. They pulled a book off the library. It opened a secret door. So you're standing there, you know, the rogue. You're a different rogue last week, but you're a rogue. The rogue is the one that pulled the book, red book. The bookshelves are full of books. Secret door popped open. Human sorcerer's in that room. You were still downstairs?
Or I believe I was.
You're still downstairs.
I'm with him.
You're with the ranger and the sorcerer.
And from my get, I kind of am just a beat it up and I'm following him.
Okay.
So I should follow them too. Are we, if everybody's, I mean, I think there's some other people with me, but I'm going to go, those people have mysteriously vanished, so I'm going to go upstairs with everyone else.
Comes up?
Yeah, should we?
Where's
my person?
This is my
person. You're big, look at that. Why are you so big?
I know gnomes are small, but.
So the you're in a library, and the bookshelves open, the secret door. The secret door is a room that's crammed full of books, right? So think
conspiracy theorist, you know, stacks of books on top of stacks of books, bookshelves made of stacks of books, right? Lots and lots of books. There is a table.
Talk about what you
want to
do next.
And underneath the table, there's a heaven wooden chest with clawed iron feet.
Now the map will give you good luck.
And sticking out of the chest, there appears to be a skeleton or something wearing leather armor.
We can all take a door.
So there is a chest half open with a human skeleton kind of shoved into it.
Attractive.
Enter the room. Enter, stand. Walk inside. It looks like the skeleton is clutching a note or something in his hand.
I want the note. I want to take the note.
No, somebody like, don't be rude.
Drow grabs the note, or no, the half orc. Can the half orc read?
No. That's up for debate.
It was the tray of minis.
I don't think it says you can read it.
They moved it back.
I don't think so.
Or they
well, it says
the
she had a mini.
It says
here,
you can speak.
Oh, did I put it away? Was it little like.
He might have put it away.
Yeah, it was a nightwing.
He put it away.
Who's who here?
That was very generous of you.
Do you prefer where you are?
So you grab a note from the skeleton's hand.
Cool. What does it say?
Note in the skeleton's hand.
Sorry.
Here. I don't know what to do with that.
You were downstairs.
Sure. I have to read.
Yes.
No, I don't read.
As you get close, you see the skeleton, and it appears that the skeleton, knowing your knowledge of drow traps, activated some kind of trap while opening the chest, and poison dart shot into his arm. You can still see the dart. Looks like he died of poison. Right there.
Okay.
The chest is open, however.
Damn.
Wow. So someone died opening it, and happily it wasn't us.
It's actually kind of difficult to find that. There's a lot of words I can't fucking say. A most pathetic servant, I am not a messiah sent to you, which no one cares about you. By the dark powers of this land, I have not come to lead you on a path to immortality, however many souls you have bled on your forbidden altar, however many visitors have been tortured in your dungeon. Know that you are not the ones who brought me to this beautiful land. You are but worms writhing in my earth. You say that you are cursed, your fortune spent. You abandoned love for madness, took solace in the bosom of another woman, and stirred a stillborn son. Cursed by darkness, of that I have no doubt. Save you from your wretchedness, I think not. I much prefer you as you are, your dreadlord and master. I can't say that name.
Well, guys, if you want what's in that chest, I'm not good for it. Go for it yourselves.
I can't say that name. Go for it.
Yeah, the chest is wide open. Inside the chest, there's still lots of scrolls and other books all over the place. The chest appears to have three black leather books. There are some scrolls. There is more paperwork inside the chest.
Grab it.
Wait, is this all upstairs?
Yes.
Yeah.
They're on the second floor.
I'm reaching in the chest.
Grab everything out of the chest.
No fear.
So these papers are like in a folder.
I'll buy them off of you for a very good price.
Didn't find anything.
They don't necessarily come out in the order that they were in when they went in.
There's a. First of all, the jewelry box itself looks like it's definitely. It's made of silver.
Oh, so he's being true.
On the corners of it.
Yeah.
It's a sizable jewelry box. Wouldn't fit in a standard box.
Oh,
but I guess
in the bosom of another woman?
This is the dirt.
Does that mean this is a woman?
Yes.
Okay, guys.
Not me.
This is the. This is the deed to the windmill that we traveled
some
through.
Sort of silvery material.
That got 100 years older.
Yeah.
Overnight.
Paid 500 GP for it, apparently.
Does it say how it? Any insight into how it got 100 years old in one night?
Old bone grinder. That's an old bones to Rosewalda and Thornbit. Who the heck is? Are those the kids?
The kids introduce themselves as Rose and Thorn.
Oh, okay. So the dad's will leaves everything to the kids.
Yeah, Rosenthor and Gerb. So this room, and you see just a very, very small room in front of you.
Oh, he might have, like, I don't know, like, committed adultery or something.
Is that he? Or is that she?
Strahd?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. I mean, if he's
I'm just
metagaming here, but...
Yeah, remember,
Lord.
Toilet that we're used to.
Lord
used
and...
It's just weirdly phrased to say the bosom of another woman.
Well, yeah, we have adultery.
Probably
his wife. The pathetic servant is probably a dude. And then he probably had a wife.
You also find these things in the chest.
You're a little surprised how unfancy.
That's probably what the woman, the woman in the rocking chair. That was probably the still.
Wait, Fire Stillborn, but it was a doll.
I know, but she said she actually lost her daughter like, years ago.
Do you remember the
spiritual weapon?
Sweet.
And protection from poison. You're probably gonna
well,
want these.
Well, good.
In
that's
room.
This is my job here is to protect
as
y'all.
Opening up the door,
how can I help?
As the door
at your service.
So, but you know, this is talking about a stillborn son, like that woman that we talked to with the doll. Did she say something about?
You're obsessed with that girl.
Well, no, just because it's talking about it again.
Who is Gustav?
Shells on both sides.
Do we know who Gustav is?
On the shelves themselves.
Apparently,
maybe
Gustav
that's
Durst.
His house?
I don't know. There's Edgar Durst, who apparently is his dad to these two kids. And
is it the dead guy?
Gustav Durst, which he could be.
It's a trap. Oh my god!
No, Gustav and Elizabeth
yeah,
were the parents.
There was,
magic
okay.
Gustav and Elizabeth were the parents of Rosenthorn.
Okay, so Edgar is. Who's Edgar?
Maybe older brother? Was there an older brother? Or maybe an uncle or something? Because Gustav and Elizabeth were supposed to be the.
Okay.
Ismark is a brother of somebody.
Gustav sold something to Edgar for 7,500. I don't know what it is.
Is Edgar's last name is still Durst?
Yeah, they're both the Durst.
Do you want to play?
I do.
Do! Play.
Give him a character sheet?
Yeah.
Here, you want to try to make sense of this?
All of a sudden, the morning.
Okay, they're in there.
Wax. Words,
tell me if, the woman is the one that with the dead dog.
I can't do that because I can't read the 16.
This whole side of the table can't read.
Dwarf cleric, dragonborn sorcerer, human paladin.
The puns are
just cracks you across the face.
Nice. Who did you get to sign?
Is this
Cody?
Oh god.
I might
jump in and out. You understand?
Okay.
So they're in a death house.
Okay.
They are searching for a monster that's supposed to be upstairs. They're on the second floor. They found a secret room.
Okay.
Inside the secret room, they have found some papers. They have found some treasure. There are also a lot of books. The secret room is in a library, so the library is well apportioned with all sorts of books.
Okay.
In this room, there are a second set of books crammed in like by a paranoid schizophrenic. They're stacked on top of each other. There's just piles of masses of books.
Okay.
Everywhere.
Okay.
No one's really explored anything or investigated anything. Yeah. Charged in.
So I don't know how Edgar's related to.
I'm gonna investigate the stacks of books. Check out the stacks of books around.
In the
room.
In the secret room. The books in the secret room all seem to be dealing with the summoning and or control of extraplanar entities, demons, summoning rituals.
Because it surprised you.
So many demons?
Primarily demons, some extraterrestrial stuff. Or extra planar stuff.
Okay.
I'm going to have everybody on the top floor roll initiative. Because we're still chilling down there.
There's a lot of stuff from the priests of Ossibus. Osybus. Extensive rituals from them. You know, they're all stamped from, you know, priests of Ossibus summoning rituals. And there's probably, you know, half the rituals are from them, from the same abbey or whatever.
How about 20 to 15?
The books in the main library, history books, scholarly treatises on a variety of natural phenomena and other things like that, some fiction. You're not actually recognizing, you know, you've done some time in libraries. You're not recognizing a lot of, like, kind of the standard texts that you're used to seeing, you know, like, Grimsmith's History of the Realms is not on the shelf, and that's kind of a classic, right? You're not seeing the standard encyclopedias, right? You're not seeing anything written by the Harpers or anything written by anything that you would be more accustomed to seeing in normal libraries. So weird, surprising.
So what's the like? There's priests and clerics. Like, so I mean, are these like? Have I heard of these Asibus priests?
You have not.
Yeah, that hits it. Okay. Kill the broom.
That's 10. Okay.
In fact, on like in their like divinity section in the bookshelves, right?
Yeah.
The lists of gods and the pretty much there's only the Morning Lord and the Night Queen, and there's not a lot of other deities. There's no chapter on Maliki at all. In fact, you start looking and there's no mention of Maliki. You know, anywhere in the religion section, which is a surprise, right? She's a major deity.
No,
she's
just mentioned.
The
just
books seem very odd.
I do that naturally. What if he's actually new?
So you can cast those spells.
Okay. So they're like, I get it.
You read the spell and it does its thing. So you don't have to use your spell slots for casting those, correct? Magic items.
Which
very
means
good.
Something's going to try to kill you all soon, right? Then
let's
I have
go out the room.
All right, so you head up to the third floor.
Since nobody else is driving the story.
I mean, is there any other...
Yeah, real quick.
On this floor?
Can I do a quick look around and just see if I see anything else that
looks odd? We've already seen this room and the other room.
No, I mean, but in the, like, where the chest was.
In the room with the chest, again, the rituals that he saw, lots of them from the same kind of abbey or church, written in the same hand, all of them seem like pretty advanced magic. Like, you're surprised by how almost cliched some of these spells seem in their power and magnitude. Give me an insight check.
16. And insight is wisdom, and I have +3 wisdom.
You're reading one of the summoning rituals and comparing it to another one. It's got like the same language, but it says it does different things. And you start to think that perhaps most of these rituals are not authentic. They seem to have been falsified in some way or forged. You don't think they would work.
Someone got bunk rituals.
But I think these are going to work.
This door not open. I sure hope those do.
Yeah.
if you're casting pure poison, you probably need it to work.
Yeah. You generally cast that when you need it.
I'm going to follow behind him.
Okay, up to the third floor?
Yes.
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay, the third floor, the stairs end on the third floor. There's,
Travis, you can pass that skills over here and switch out with the other one.
Awesome, thank you. She's gonna eat the purple
ones. Gotta eat all the purple ones.
Okay. Do it.
I only like the purple ones.
You come out on the landing, there's a large suit of armor across from the exit of the stairwell. There's oil lamps mounted along the oak paneled walls. The oak panels are covered in woodland scenes with falling leaves and tiny critters.
Nice.
Is the armor human?
I have leather armor.
At all.
There are door to your left, door straight ahead, kind of an alcove with three doors to your right, and a door to your immediate right.
Where do you want to go?
Left to right.
Right.
Wearing the leather armor looks
Let's
like
go
a
on the very left.
So you turn to the left, you kick in, you open the door.
Let's drive the plot.
Rogue is not amused. Rogue said right.
I know we do.
You want to go right or you want to go left?
Rogue goes north because Rogue didn't go.
Rogue's going right. Fuck you guys. Hi, Rogue.
You open the door.
Rogue's mad.
Dust, so you walk kind of around, you're not interacting with the armor, you walk into the room. Dust and cobwebs shroud an elegantly appointed bedroom.
Yeah, that would be an investigation check.
There's a small area to the right that has what appears to be a nursery or something in it. There's some slatted glass doors that seem to open up onto a balcony.
When you touch these robes, they're warm. And now
I have five. That's creepy. What can we see outside of the...
So it's very foggy and gray like it always is in Barovia. You can see out and you're looking out into the kind of the city center, but you're off kind of to the side, so you're kind of looking into the city center. It's a normal day. There's a large bed, two tables, an empty wardrobe, a large mirror on one wall.
But we have mirrors.
There's a crib
and running water
in the nursery area.
I want to go investigate that mirror.
All right.
Curious.
Interesting. Okay, so you start approaching the mirror. When? We will roll for initiative.
Dun, 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 dun. We finally progress the plot far enough to go to combat.
No, I don't have any of my dice.
Like, I don't know which die you want. So.
It's this one.
Well, I'm not attacking you.
Yeah, you're attacking something.
Okay, well, I rolled
amazing. I'm attacking the
what's your dex?
That's what I'm looking for.
So, shrouded in kind of cackling blue and gray and purple necrotic evilness, a female specter rises up from the floor as you approach the mirror. Seems extremely pissed off, seems like she's going to attack.
Ooh.
You missed the wall.
I have advantage saving throws against magic.
No, I got really bad. Just so
you know. Well, thank you.
Yeah.
Honestly,
I 16 plus 2. There's just one of them, right?
First of all,
but they're magic, so that might be.
Open up the door.
Dice. Like,
I mean, dragon wars.
All right. Do you have your initiative?
Yep.
Birch, what is your initiative?
Right under it.
Five. Plus
damage.
It's dex plus one.
Once you reach the top,
and the mace goes crashing behind, but smashing into the wall.
Just dex.
So.
Arana.
Yeah. So it's a five.
That one was magic.
It's plus zero.
Plus one is like, but 11 is still zero. Yeah, zero.
Orana?
Five. I'm going last.
Oh, I have 14.
14 initiative?
We'll see who gets
Dante? Horobi has a 9.
I'm Thompson Jar. I live in these forests.
Moxie.
22.
Nice. And Josh, 18. Gets an 18. Very nice. All right, so Moxie, as you're watching the drow sneak quietly into the room, stealthily to explore a mirror that's mounted against one wall, suddenly a female specter rises up in the middle of the room, howling in rage.
It's more than a whiff. I could smell it.
You can stab it in the butt.
I guess we're going to stab it.
Absolutely.
Can you like?
What do you want to stab it with?
I mean, is there a physical thing there?
Call me just my short sword. So I'm gonna call you Mr. Jar. We're not gonna get.
I don't think it would be a thing.
Don't get fresh with me.
That is 12.
Isn't that like an image rather than a physical thing? I mean, is it a physical thing or is it an image?
It looks very kind of like classic ghost.
So it has a physicality.
I think.
I thought classic ghost was see through.
Yeah, it's translucent. Shimmery.
Kind of like a smoke almost.
I mean,
right?
It's probably fine.
That's my boy's picture.
Does your hand go through it?
We're going to find out.
Okay, hit it for. I don't have an issue.
What did you roll?
12.
A 12 hits. So you swing out with your
short sword
and you strike the specter.
First, I'm going to cast false life on myself.
Plus 3.
Five.
Five damage.
The specter takes 5.
I said 5.
You did it. Good job.
So Haley, you've charged into the room and struck with your short sword. Josh, you're up. There's a ghost that's just risen up in front of you.
Okay, so I'm gonna pull out my maul and swing for the fences with my maul because I like to smash things.
Of course you are.
And I roll a 9 plus my strength, right?
Yep.
Plus 3, so I roll a 12.
That's a hit?
Yes. All right, and my maul
is
a 2d6.
Roll this twice.
Yeah, it might be a reaction.
For 11 damage. Plus 3.
Wow. It's taking a ton of damage. The specter is furious. She seems to be moving towards the crib in a kind of protective motion, like she's trying to defend the crib from you guys or something.
I should go up there.
Okay, I think there's something else going on here, guys. Hold on a second.
Taylor, you're up.
I think we got
to destroy
the
crib. Can I see the crib being empty?
The crib appears empty from where you're standing, that there are, you know, kind of like things hanging over the side, so it is possible there's something in the crib that you can't see.
Maybe I can go like stealth and just like steal from the crib.
See if there's anything there.
Yeah. Oh, where are we in all of this shenanigans?
There's a large bedroom with a nursery attached to it, so you're coming through the door.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I'm just gonna hit it.
You charge in and attack with a. Is this a ranged weapon?
No. My two short swords.
Short swords, got it, okay.
Yep, my first short sword hits with a 19.
You stabbed the specter.
Okay, and then it is a 1d6 plus 3. Oh, gracious. That's a 6. And then my offhand.
Yes.
20.
Right. Highly count crit or modified?
No, modified. And then it's a 1d3 plus 3. And that is, so that's 5.
Holy cow. You guys have done 30 points of damage in the first half of the round. Not bad at all. The specter turns, you know, he's moving toward the thing, you hit it, it turns towards the paladin with their, the half-orc with the maul, and the specter, like, reaches into your soul and tries to grab your soul, like, inside you and grips. Oh! This is fantastic. So that's a hit, that's a 20 against armor class.
My armor class 16. Damn.
Okay, you're gonna take 10 points of damage.
I'm almost dead. I'm down to 2.
Okay, and then you need to make a DC 10 Constitution save.
Just believe, and you can punch him.
Roll higher than 10. That's higher than 10.
And you take your
yes. It's working.
Your hit point maximum is reduced by an amount equal to the damage taken. So what was your hit point maximum before I hit you?
12. My hit points were 12.
Okay, so your hit point maximum is then 10.
They don't know. All right.
So that knocks
so
me out.
No, you're done. You're at 2. You didn't take any damage.
Okay.
If you get healed though, you can only get healed to 10.
Oh, okay.
Got it?
Okay.
Okay, and then the specter, after grabbing his soul, moves into what appears to be kind of a defensive position at the crypt. So she's moved through you, kind of, and is now standing next to the crypt. Dante, you're up. You're standing at the doorway. The half-orc has rushed in with his ball, slammed the specter. The short swords come flying in. She grabs his soul and runs away.
I'm gonna burn it with spell damage.
Got it? What are we casting?
Give myself advantage, both chaotic and stuff.
Yeah.
He's really excited.
I'm gonna hit it for
23.
Is that hit?
23 is a hit?
Yeah, my base confirmed.
If it doesn't hit, we got a problem.
I'm really guided by base.
Alright. I know music plays.
I know, right? Let's do 16 points of damage.
What type of damage?
Let's do. Cold damage.
That's right.
All right.
Hey, there's like a spooky ghost.
Sure.
Would you like to send me on the chaos trip?
No, this is good. The specter looks badly damaged. Some of your magic appears to have hit the crib as well. But everything's cool. Dante is finished. We're not going to kick off your chaos magic this round. Is that okay? Does it go off every round?
Is it a woman?
That's fine.
Okay. Melissa, Birch is up. Just because I have a feeling you'll kill it. Let's not everyone get a chance. Birch, go ahead.
Oh, I was going to cure wounds.
Cure light wounds.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah. cure wounds. Regains a number of hit points equal to 1d8 plus my spell casting ability modifier. Which is, I forget, something good. Well,
I have an idea.
2 plus, what's my spell casting ability?
Whiz.
I hope you get attacked by a broom.
Plus 3.
You'll be able to get up there and
watch. But isn't there something else too?
Do you not just do the maximum, or do we roll in the sleep?
We roll healing. We get maximum hit points when we start.
Okay.
Then we roll our healing. So she's got 2 plus 3 plus proficiency.
Yeah.
You can make
are
you trying to do a spell?
Yeah.
Cure wounds.
Not light wounds, but just cure wounds.
What does it say?
It's 1d8 plus my spellcasting ability modifier.
Okay. Spellcasting ability modifier is proficiency plus wisdom modifier, so that would be 5.
Five. So 2 plus 5. 7.
That'd give me 9. Awesome.
Heal.
You can't go higher than 10 anyways.
Yeah.
End of round 1. Round 2. Haley, you're up again. You're about 5 feet away from the specter. It looks badly damaged. It's starting to kind of lose its focus.
I feel like I'm on an airplane.
Comment are 6 seconds, so you're just like, that's what you see in the room. So busy.
Yeah. Sorry.
15 is a hit.
I am going to.
Plus 3.
So 7.
Jump. It dissipates.
You killed it.
It goes like double
speed. Yeah. I almost lost my butt there, guys.
All the way up. I'm gonna go up to the crib.
30, right? Oh, yeah, you go up to the crib, and in the crib, there appears to be
like
a baby specter glowing in the crib.
Baby specter.
Baby specter.
Baby specter.
Squeeze it.
There you are.
sorry.
Does it look evil? Like, is it trying to hurt us?
No.
I mean, we don't have to kill it if it's not
one
bad,
of the things you
right?
Guys, so flashback, you remember...
A compassionate thing.
When you came into the house, there was... Yeah. Mom and Dad,
right?
Yes. There was Rose and Thorn,
yep.
And Dad was still holding a small bundle in his arms.
So it was a family.
And then there's also
a
reference to a stillborn Ida.
I'm
going to
try to shoot a fireball down.
What's well, so one of the things that talks about a stillborn baby?
It's fire diplomacy.
So if the baby's not threatening to us.
Well,
the paladin can see if it's evil.
No.
Can we check and see if it's evil?
Hey guys, Haley had a good idea.
Yeah. I tried saying that in the middle of all the fighting. I was like, let's not fight, it's protecting the kid. Yeah. No, I mean, he said it was protecting the kid, but it did seem threatening.
Yeah. Hey, it popped right up in front of me. Like, I'm sorry, guys.
It's
like so amazing.
Well, it also did 10 damage to you. I mean,
yes.
Detective Ash.
Yes.
Definitely. Right,
thank
very
you.
Evil.
Very evil. Okay, I'm killing it. Sorry, guys. Do I need to roll for initiative again?
No,
or do
no,
I
no.
Just
you got
to push it.
Are you
yeah,
good?
Coup de gras.
I'm good.
Are you good? So then you probably need to leave the room.
No, I'm okay with killing evil things.
Good.
I'm good. So I kill evil, right? I don't like evil.
Well, I don't know about babies, okay?
Wait a minute. I have an idea. What if I do lay on hands?
You're going to try to heal it or something?
Yeah.
All right.
It's gonna be a good baby.
Let's do a
good baby.
Okay, 1d6.
Give me an attack roll.
Attack.
You'll get AC 12.
Healing damages, and that doesn't
really. I roll an 8 plus 3, so 11. No.
So the god of your life, what, I don't know who you worship.
No, I worship.
Don't say Maliki.
Maliki, we have unicorns over here.
Maliki, we all worship.
I've been staring at small numbers all day.
Spoiler alert.
Maliki's the best god.
I don't think. I
think he already saved
it. Worship a god.
Just say it.
Per se.
Spoiler alert. They're all the same.
So yeah, you summon the divinity of your god to heal this evil spirit, and your god basically responds with, no, kill that.
Oh, I'm on the path of a war god.
Yeah. This, we're not having pity on this. Right, Maul?
Yes.
Maul, smash the entire crib.
Awesome.
Dead. You'll get a bonus. We'll get an inspiration for killing a baby.
Yes.
There you go. Okay. So you were also going up to explore the mirror.
I turn around, I go back to the mirror.
Why are we killing babies?
And I'm having a thought of maybe there's something behind the mirror.
Absolutely.
Can I just try and smash the mirror? Or do
you
I can
use it. You want to smash
can
the mirror?
Can I kill the paladin?
Yeah.
All right,
take the easy way.
Maul to the mirror.
Yeah.
Maul to the mirror. You smash the mirror into bits.
Oh, we don't.
And it appears behind the mirror there may be a door.
Hey, guys, look at what I found. Who wants to go first?
Yeah,
you
do. You die. No, he likes it. He likes
it. Is it a little door or a big door?
It looks like a standard door,
okay,
but it's secret. Secret door, right? But it's, you know, there's a knob and a handle.
I'd like to open it and go inside and check out the room.
You open
I want
to
investigate before I step inside.
You open the door, there is immediately a stairwell leading up.
Ooh.
Cobwebs in the staircase. Right? It looks very narrow, very creepy.
Is she transparent?
Yeah.
Okay. I want to find out what's up the stairs.
Was this house like butted up against the mountains?
No. This house is actually, so most of the houses
nobody
in Barovia.
Wants to investigate the other door before we go upstairs?
There'll be four or five houses on a block, you know, kind of together. Look like they were built at the same time. This house is definitely standing by itself, which is right. There are other freestanding houses.
Yeah,
most of them look like restaurants or something.
Because I did ask
and
I killed
unusual.
The paladin for killing
and it's not, the cliff is actually
try,
like
so
you were walking to the mayor's house. The rolling hills and, you know, kind of base of the cliff is kind of where the mayor's mansion is. Which is not, the mayor's mansion isn't a much larger house, but it was at the end of the street. You guys are about a third of the way down the street.
You know what this probably is? This is probably the dungeon that we read about. This is probably where they torture the people.
Well, I'm taking a vote, guys. I'm taking a vote. I want to find out what's upstairs.
We should investigate the other doors.
We want to go upstairs
and
we
want to
see other doors first.
We should investigate the other doors.
Okay, well, I'll come back to my found stairwell.
We should investigate the motives of the paladin.
Yeah, paladin under investigation.
So in this room that you're in, there is a door.
He's chaotic good, and I'm neutral, and I'm not.
No, there's a nursery. That's the nursery. There are no other doors in this room. If you go back out, there's a door to your left. Two or three doors in a little alcove over there, and a door kind of straight ahead.
I'd like to investigate the door to the left.
Okay, so you go immediately to your left in room 14.
You don't watch him walk into a trap.
Open the door without checking for traps.
I set the trap.
Hey, I got a poison thing. I got some stuff.
I don't even know if I can set traps, but that's gonna be a thing.
It appears to be a storage room. Dusty shelves line the walls and the rooms. A few shelves have folded sheets, blankets, and old bars of soap on them. There is a cobweb-covered broom leaning against the far wall.
Which is broom?
That was uneventful. So then we'll go.
Boy, nobody's ever used this broom in here, have they? Okay, well, let's see what's in the rooms on the other side.
Close the door, leave the door open.
When you move through them, leave it open. It takes more movement.
Okay, you move down to the alcove. When you go into the alcove, there's a door to your right and to your left.
Anybody want to take turns on this door?
I'm hanging back. I'm
sick of being the one progressing the story. You can do it.
Okay.
Do it. Run with it. We're following you.
I'll open the right door.
Okay, on the door on the right, you open the door into a master suite, the master bedroom, right? Double doors to this room have dusty panes of stained glass on them. Inside the room, there are furnishings, include a four-poster bed. There is embroidered curtains and tattered cashmere veils. There's two empty wardrobes on each wall. There's a vanity with a jewelry box on it in front of a large mirror. There is a large padded chair. There's a table. It looks around the corner like there may be a washroom or something.
Is that correct?
I'd like to go investigate.
I'm a gnome and I like shiny things. Gnomes like shiny things, right?
Correct.
I like shiny things. I'd like to go check out the jewelry box, please.
All right, you approach the jewelry box. The jewelry box itself. The jewelry box itself looks like it may be worth a lot.
Wow. You're picking up card. Something's gonna happen.
Do you want to try to open it?
Sure.
You open it up. There's a beautiful platinum necklace inside.
Nice.
Necklace. There's also some rings inside the jewelry box.
Cool. Anybody want some stuff?
Money.
You guys can just. I'm just throwing you cards. You guys can figure out who gets what later.
I don't.
Or you can try to pawn stuff or whatever you want to do. So
anybody want to touch the shiny
at the foot of the bed?
I just like them. I mean, but if other people are wearing them,
okay. So
perhaps a dumb waiter or something in one corner, a shoot, you know, kind of thing.
I don't know. Oh, 75 gold pieces. 25 gold pieces each. 750 gold pieces.
Rogue wants
stuff. Are you coming next week, though? Because you're not coming next week. I'll take it. Because I'm going to be here next week.
I'll pawn it off on someone.
Okay, well, I leave these guys to their shinies. I go investigate at the next door.
If I don't come, I'll pawn it.
Okay, so you open door 13.
I'll write it down, and if you don't come,
you check the door, right? Door doesn't seem trapped. Looks fine.
Okay, so
nice narrow wooden door. Open the door. Bathroom, right? There's a bathtub. That's it.
Okay, so I start
rustling in the storage closet. Check the room.
Yes, you forfeit the necklace if you don't show
it. So I alert these guys who are too busy paying attention to their newfound lord.
Wait, what's alerting to me?
Guys, there's noises going on out here.
Okay, so it's a 14.
Leave it.
Okay, let's go listen.
What kind of noises?
Something coming from that storage room.
Okay. We left the door open, right?
Told me to.
Yeah, I mean, but can we see?
Yeah, right, we left the door open.
Can we peek out the door? Try to
walk back down and peek around. Give me a perception check.
Eight.
Yeah. Storage closet, sheets, towels.
Okay, so you
can I make a you know,
absolutely. So you're standing in the hallway checking around, rustling noises.
It's not even anything.
I'm
I got an 11.